What is going on, everybody? It is X Factor Xbox here, back with another rebuild. I know I haven't done one in quite a while. It's been almost a month, I think. And we're back with a rebuild. So we did the Bengals and we've done the Jets already. So they are crossed off the list, I should say. I do have the updated rosters, so I don't know if I'll rebuild them again, but that could very likely happen. And the team we will be rebuilding this time is going to be the Jacksonville Jaguars. You know, their defense looks a lot different, with no Jalen Ramsey, no AJ Boye, it's Clyde Campbell, Telvin Smith, who I don't know if he retired or not. I don't know what happened to Telvin Smith, but he's no longer on the team anymore. And their team looks almost unrecognizable from that 2017 AFC Championship run. But hopefully we can restore the 2017 Jaguar form in this rebuild. Alright, let's have a quick look at this Jaguar roster here. So at QB, we will be having Gardner Minshew at our starting QB. He has 70 hidden development, I'm pretty sure he's 23, yeah, he's 23 years old. He's got some great pieces. He's got DJ Chark, D.D. Westbrook, Chris Conley, Laviska Shenault, who's probably going to have hidden development. I'm going to want to give him hidden development. Leonard Fournette has superstar. They added Tyler Eifert in free agency. Hopefully he doesn't get hurt like he did for the Bengals a lot. Moving on to their defense. Their defense looks a lot different from their 2017 team. I'm pretty sure the only dude who's back from that team, maybe DJ Hit, I don't know. But their defense tackles don't look too bad. Kilavon Chase on hidden development. I'm going to give Cedar Henderson hidden. I'm probably going to give Laviska Shenault hidden development, so... I'm going to do that, and we'll jump into... I don't know if I'll make a trade, though. I might make a trade or two, but... so I'll also update the rookies' contracts, and then I'll maybe do some trades. Alright, actually, I decided I'm not going to make any trades, because it's going to be kind of like we're going into Madden 21. I don't know why that's so bright. But, so we'll simulate here to, what the heck was that? So we're going to simulate here to mid-season and see where this team is at. So let's go ahead and send them straight to the mid-season. All right, here we are at mid-season. It looks like somebody's frustrated and we are 3-4-1. So actually not that bad of a start to the year. I thought we're going to be a little bit worse as some guys will get upgrade points here. I forgot to put auto scouting on, so I'm going to do that right now. Alright, so I just changed it to auto scouting, and now we get to negotiate with players here. So the number one person to negotiate right now is Keelan Cole. They're going to call that Allen. So really, I'm not too worried about bringing any of these guys back, honestly. They're not really, like, starters or, like, important. I also forgot to, this is not a great start, forgot to also edit the depth chart a little bit and put you up to receiver number 3. So it revealed that Minshew does have star development. I surprised. I'm such a big brain that Henderson's already 78, so he's progressing pretty well. I'm gonna move Yannick Ngakoue to right outside the linebacker here. Do that quickly. I'm sorry if it's a little bit bright. I don't know how to fix that. Hopefully it's fixed later. So we're gonna put Chase on there at starting right end. Need to look at specialist here. He's gonna be our rush left end. Kevin Bryant is gonna be our rush D tackle, sub linebacker, slot corner. Dickel in 9 defenses. I think we're gonna put Henderson back over there. And I want to put uh, Pavlyuchka in the slot. So I'm gonna do that, and then we'll see what our and see if we make the playoffs. Probably not though. All right, so it looks like we did not make the playoffs, and we finished the year. It's cool that we just like won two games the rest of the year. That's pretty cool. Our division was terrible. Let's go ahead and check out stats here. It's just not a good year. Minshew was not. That's not good. He 3,547 yards, 27 touchdowns, 13 picks. That's not good. Interceptions could be down, touchdowns could be up. Leonard Fournette did even surpass 900 yards, had only 4 touchdowns, so our offense was not very good. Moving Olivier Chenault to slot didn't really do too much. DJ Chark had 900 yards, 9 catches. Eifert was actually not that bad. Blocking, so we can check out blocking. Hopefully, Kerryon's let up 16 sacks defensively. 148 tackles from Joe Schobert. 70 tackles for loss from Al Woods. Quite a bit of double digit tackles for losses. Sacks 6.5 for Josh Allen. If I'm being, those kind of look like defensive player of the year numbers. Joe Schobert with quite a bit of high stats. Miles Jack had 5 interceptions. Ooh, we can see catches allowed now. 60 catches allowed for Joe Schobert. Ooh, that's not good. Pass deflections, 4 from Ronnie Harrison. Kicking Josh Sheinbaum is 5 field goals. Not a good thing. I don't think any of our guys won yearly awards. Drew Brees wins MVP. I think these are final, unless they're not. And we are in the AFC. AFC player obviously goes to Baker Mayfield because the Browns are very OP in sim. We had nobody. Of course, defensive player of the year goes to actually Miles Jack. Schobert finished second. So looks like we got some bright spots on that defense. Offensive rookie of the year went to Justin Herbert. Minshew finished third. Defensive rookie of the year goes to Devin Bush. Why only one guy from the draft class? Look at the individual awards. I don't think any of our guys were gonna win that. So wow. Mozak was third for best linebacker. That's kind of dumb. So not a good year. Now I'm gonna assume we had one of the best defense because we have number 1 and 2 for defensive player of the year. So we should have like the top 5 deep. Wow, actually one of the worst defenses. Probably because the tackles and stuff. So actually really not even that cool. So I'll go and upgrade the guys and we'll go straight to the offseason. Alright, so here we are in the Super Bowl week. It looks like the Saints and the Chargers will be facing Drew Brees' former team going against his present team. Let's see if anybody went for developments. I'm not going to be surprised if nobody did. Nobody did. Minshew has a lot of people actually have upgrade points. Defensively, Miles Jack goes up to superstar. All right, Ronnie Harrison goes up to superstar. So a couple of huge upgrades here for the defense. Defense looks like it's coming together. Just give it like a next year, and then defense should be one of the top ones. I'm pretty sure the yearly awards did the same. Drew Brees wins MVP. Yeah, y'all already saw that. So let's go ahead and simulate. Since there's nobody I want to resign here, we're just gonna simulate to. Actually, we might as well simulate next week. But see you guys. See if there's anybody free agency. Most likely not, but we'll might as well check. All right. So the Super Bowl winners are the New Orleans Saints. I don't know if you can see that. 35-24. As you can see, nobody I want to re-sign. Everybody can walk in free agency. I do not care. So let's see if anybody's in free agency. I don't think anybody gives me free agency. I'm pretty sure Everson Griffin's always there. With the updated rosters because he's a free agent. We have 50 mil and cap, we have a lot. Everson Griffin's there. Actually, quite a bit more guys than I expected. QB, we do not need QB to look for maybe one in the draft. There's Rosen right there. Running back, I don't need a running back. Quarterback could use one. Receiver could use one, but they're all not very good. I don't want to assign like the rookies because that'd be kind of like cheating, because really they should have. The only time I do it is in the final year, because that's when their contracts are gonna be up and stuff. Tight end we could use, but again there is no good tight ends available. Here there is no good O linemen. I'm no good left end. You could maybe use a D tackle. Chris Jones wouldn't be that bad of a signing. Let's go ahead and try to offer up on Chris Jones. We'll give him a 5-year deal. How about this? 93 points. We'll go back to him. Don't want a defensive end. Lineman court is pretty set. Corner we could use. But again, there is nobody good there. Free safety. Nobody. So there's really nobody in the first year at all. So really, I guess we could try to go all in on Chris Jones here. So we're going to give him a massive contract here. 98 points. I'm going to at least get like a 5-point bid over the other guys. So yeah, there we go. 101 points. So really, that's the only guy I'm going to negotiate with. And then we'll just send straight to the draft. So let's go see if you maybe get Chris Jones. All right, so Chris Jones rejects. That sucks. I'm not honestly surprised because you have to bid like 30 points over just to get the guy. He went to the Chargers. That's cool. Chargers that bid us the last second, and obviously there's nobody that's rebidded on. So let's just head straight to the playoff. The draft. All right, so here we are in the draft. I'm pretty sure we have two first-round draft picks. So our first pick is going to be at pick number 4. I'm not going to be using the 2021 draft class because this is an offline franchise. And if I tried online, it would actually take longer because my connection to EA servers is never the greatest. So let's just go ahead and send straight to the 4th overall pick as Cliff Tyson goes. Actually, we do not have our first-round pick. That kind of sucks. So what could we use? There's Caleb Billingsley, early first rounder. Our offense was not good at all. So maybe getting another receiver? Is that really the thing we should do? Defense, we could grab another corner. I'm being completely honest. Let's go and check out the corners. And we didn't even scout any corners. That's cool. What else could we use on offense? Tight end, I don't really want to draft a tight end top 5, that's kind of dumb. Defense, though, D-tackle, since we missed out on Chris Jones. Now these guys look particularly, like, outstanding. The only guy I think is really worth taking here is Caleb Billingsley. So we're going to take him. He's burner speed. So I don't know if really taking a break here. I think we honestly should trade down. There's this guy here. I think the best thing we can do here is to trade down. Probably we might. We could get Antonio Stevens would actually not be that bad. So we're going to trade down. Out of this spot here. I want a first pick next year. That'd be nice. So no real good offers. Those are all kind of bad offers. So we'll trade down and I'll see you guys once I make a trade down offer. Alright, so it looks like we're just gonna take our players here because the Cardinals were wanting too much. So we're going to go ahead and take, who do we take here at? Oh my gosh, this is not like a top tier draft class. Michigan O-lineman, he looks really good. I kind of want to take that receiver. I want to take a receiver or a D-tackle. Gosh, dude, this is so tough. I guess we'll go with the guy that I want the most, Caleb Billingsley. Could maybe trade away one of our other receivers for a stud defensive player, I don't know. Caleb Billingsley, we're going to take him. He's a 74 overall hidden, ranked 9th in true value. We got him at 4, 74 overall hidden development, 94 speed. Honestly, I thought it was going to be a little bit higher. So he's probably going to replace somebody. most likely D.D. Westbrook. I actually want to go ahead and look at D.D. Westbrook. Whoever's the oldest, I'm pretty sure that's D.D. Westbrook. He's 26, though, but seriously, we could actually trade away Chris Conley. That's what we might do. I don't know. So let's go ahead and simulate here to our next pick in the second round. Maybe one of those D tackles is there. Nope, the quarterback is still there. Tackle dead on Shields. It looked like kind of a reach. What do you want to take? Luther Atkinson? I think we might have to take Luther Atkinson. Honestly, he looks like the best. Yeah, we're going with Luther Atkinson. Best available, we need to tackle. We're going to take him 6'6", late first. Maybe his hidden development. 69 overall, nice. Development, not nice. Maybe, I don't know. We most likely got backup. So, not that great a pick. Hopefully, he was going to be a little bit better. So, similar here to the third round, see if we want to pick anybody. If that quarterback's still there, I might. Wow, he is still there. That's really tempting, actually. That's really tempting. Still available in the third round, and he's supposed to go, like, late first. So do we take him just in case Minshew doesn't work out? I think that's going to be a hard pick, probably. So we're going to take Steven Morey. Be a little bit of an odd pick. 6'9 overall, normal development. I'm hoping he's a little bit better. 94th pro card, not that bad. Definitely. I don't know what's going to happen with Minshew. Minshew didn't have the greatest year this year. He's going to be emergency just in case Minshew's like not even too good or something. Other scouted guys. There's this right tackle that looks pretty good. Matthew Richter. Take an early second round, 68 overall normal. Does not look too bad. Probably a depth alignment, so not a really strong class for us. But let's see if we can improve in year number two. Alright, so did not have the greatest draft class. This is probably one of my worst draft classes. We got Caleb Billingsley, who's probably he's probably gonna play slot, honestly, just give him the reps. Luther Atkinson, don't know. Then we just simmed out, and the CPU got a 62 right tackle named Berger. I don't know. This was not a strong draft class for where there was a couple of actually good players, but I didn't want to take him too high. I was trying to trade AJ Khan with that, so he could potentially become a trade piece. And then Chris Conley has no purpose on this team, so we're just going to release him, free up almost 2 mil on that. Did not improve, really, on defense too much. I mean, we drafted Atkinson. Avery Jones is probably going to get released, free up 2.8 mil. Defense looks promising. Just need better corners. Honestly, if we get better corners, then just and probably better tackle. We're actually gonna start Hamilton. I'm gonna want to see how much freeing up, cutting out was. That's not a very good contract. But you gotta do what we got. Make do with what we got. I think that's how the saying goes. So let's go ahead into year number. We'll say this is year number two. I don't know. Alright, teams at 81. And we'll see if any free agents are available for the cornerback position. Maybe there's a couple decent cornerbacks. Michael Davis is actually young. We'll pick up Michael Davis here. He's 25. It's not that bad of a contract. We'll sign Michael Davis for corner depth. Don't know if. Because usually in year number two, nobody has any cap room. Because, yeah, look at this. The only team that... Well, actually, it's not that bad. I'm actually going to try to trade away a couple guys. So I'll make... Maybe I'll make a trade. I don't know. But we'll see guys either midseason or when I make a trade. Alright, so we make a trade here. Trade away Al Woods. Third round pick this year. Fourth round next year for the Rams. First round pick. Projected top five. But it might not be top five. So we're taking a little bit of a gamble here. Sometimes the Rams are really good in sim, sometimes they're really bad in sim. It just depends on what man's feeling that day. So this could be a top five pick, or this could be a bottom pick. You don't know. So I think that's a good value. So that's the only trade I'm gonna make. Team looks not that bad. Didn't really improve too much. So we'll see if we can do anything different this year. Don't have that much hope for this team. Alright, here we are in week number dose. We're coming off a dub against the Minnesota Vikings. We are 1-6. Not a good start. I mean, Caleb Billingsley to slot receiver, that's why he has so much experience. I knew this was not going to be a good year. Probably a playbook change is going to be the What's Billingsley? Oh, he just has star development. That's cool. So, it's great. Nothing really. Hamilton won overall. Really, is really nothing to talk about here. This their slot receiver. Slot corner. Jahan's gonna be our slot corner. These are slots. All right. This is terrible. This is awful. This is not very good. We're probably gonna have the number one overall pick. We have one of the worst offenses. And one of the worst. Minshew is not good. 1,755 yards, 10 touchdowns. That's almost like a touchdown a game. 4 interceptions. Leonard Fournette is bottom in basically almost every single rushing category. Receiving. Billingsley's not doing. Eifert's probably our second best target besides DJ Chark. Quite a bit of sacks from Aaron Lynch. I think we should start our rookie quarterback right now. So more years stepping in. So let's see what you can do. And also we have negotiation for contracts to negotiate. We got Leonard Fournette, hasn't done anything this year. Dede Westbrook isn't done anything. O'Shaughnessy isn't done anything. Hayden Herndon's the only guy I'd really consider bringing back. And probably... maybe Cam Robinson. So I'm going to try to bring a... Trey Herndon could be maybe a depth corner for us. I mean, wants more money. Cool. Nobody I really want to negotiate with. Here, nothing's good. Nothing's good. Maybe a scheme change is part of me the thing. But, let's just sim to the end of the year. We didn't make the playoffs. Shocker. What did we finish? We finished 1-15. So it looks like it's definitely the scheme. Oh my gosh. And so it looks like we do not have an answer in Maury. We have the number one overall pick this year. Probably gonna try to spend it on a quarterback. Let's just check out the stats. They're gonna be bad anyways. Morzy through more interceptions than through double Minshew's interceptions. threw 300 more yards. So most of the quarterback, Leonard Fournette was terrible. Those are like mid 70 overall running back, or like low, or mid, at least low 70 running back numbers. Chark is our number one receiver. Billingsley finished with a solid year. That could be offensive rookie of the year numbers blocking. 14 sacks out of Cam Robinson. Tackles, 131 for Miles Jack. 60 tackles for loss, quite a bit of tackles for loss. Sacks, and had 6 interceptions, too. Those look like those that should definitely be defensive rookie of the year numbers. Defensively, catches allowed. Jack of the team. Henderson was second. So Henderson is not doing too good. Breckles, you should not be a number one corner. I doubt anybody's gonna be. We have the worst offense, so definitely an offensive change and definitely a defensive change. Unless like we, have, I don't know if that means the worst or the best. I don't know. Your awards MVP is Andrew Luck, not surprised. Todd Gurley finished 5th in there. Because of the year, Sean Payton. AFC Offensive Player of the Year, Andrew Luck. Defensive Player of the Year, Jayon Bryan. Miles Jack finished 2nd. So he won it last year, and then he finished 2nd this year. Stephen Morey finished 2nd. Billingsley finished 3rd. Defensive Rookie of the Year, we had nobody. You started, but Atkinson still made it. Individual awards, I'm not going to see anybody in there because we went 1-15. Don't pick anybody to win some awards when you're 1-15. So we're going to go ahead and simulate straight to the offseason.
Alright, here we are, the Super Bowl week. It's the Titans and Giants. Any development increase?
Any developments go up? None. What a surprise. We went 1-15. I don't expect anybody to go up in development. But Miles Jack goes up to superstar X-Factor. That is great. Trey Herndon goes up to star development. So Miles Jack is progressing very well. He now, his ability is Zone Hawk. I forget what that one was. Wilson went up in development. Nobody in the offense. But quite a bit of defense. I'm not gonna join your party. Actually, let me try to go offline. So, right, as I was saying, I'm probably gonna use an offensive scheme change. Because nobody was good at all. We saw the yearly awards. Probably gonna change. So let me actually go ahead and change the schemes real quick. Alright, so I changed up the schemes. I moved our offense scheme is now the Saints scheme, and the defensive playbook is now the Rams. Just randomly pick the defensive line. I don't know which ones are good. The Saints one hopefully is really good because their quarterbacks always go offensive, as you can tell, because Jacoby Brissett, they always send Jacoby Brissett, and then he wins like MVP every year. So let's go ahead and simulate here to the resign period. Alright, here we are in the resign period. The Giants beat the Titans by a total of 24-16. I'm looking for people to resign. Fournette, absolutely not. If we just go ahead and look at his stats. He has 11 total touchdowns in like 1,600 yards. He has less than 4 yards per carry. I'm just guessing there. Do not want to give you a long-term deal. Maybe give you a one-year deal, but you're never going to accept that, so it might as well come back to your free agency. D.D. Westbrook. We have quite a bit of receivers to replace him, and he's going to regress next year, so I'm not interested in that. Herndon. You want this deal? He's going to test that free agency for his 15 mil. 100% no. Cam Robinson, that's kind of expensive, and we can just draft a tackle in the draft. There's always good tackles to replace them, and we drafted one last year. So let's go ahead and see it to free agency. Alright, here we are in the free agent period. We have 82 mil. Hopefully those are good guys here. There's Trent Williams, Kareem Hunt, Marshall Leather. There's a couple of
big name players here at QB. I do not want to sign any of these QBs because it would be unrealistic for the Chargers to cut Justin Herbert. I mean, it could happen in real life, but it's unrealistic. Running back, we could look to grab a running back here. We'll grab Leonard Fournette on a 1 year deal. That was my thing to try here. And we're going to lower it quite a bit. There to less than 5 minutes, 50 total points. He's probably going to decline that. Oh, his extra team's big. I didn't even see that. Wow. Oops. So we'll just try that initial bid. Nobody's bidding on these running backs, nobody's receiver. The Westbrook, nobody's bidding on him. I'm not going to assign these dudes who were draft picks. The best receiver is Will Fuller. I kind of want to develop our other guys. There's some good tight ends available. Okay, we're gonna try to get OJ Howard onto a 5 year deal. 94 points. Let's go in next. Actually, let's give him a 6 year deal. 96 points. Hopefully, we can get him. Left tackle, we let our left tackle go. Cam Robinson, guard. This offensive line class is not good. Well, they're young guys, but again, I don't want to sign the draft picks because of unrealistic. A D tackle. Nobody I'm really interested in. Is here right end. We have what's his face, the other guy there. Corner is probably our number one need. So we're gonna go. We're gonna give Marshon Lattimore like QB money. I mean, we're not even close. Wow. Do we try? I feel like we should go cheaper. Get Chidobe Awuzie. Because I'm gonna have to pay Miles Jack, and I don't want to pay him Marshon Lattimore quarterback money, and pay who did I just say Miles Jack quarterback money? I'm looking at safeties. There's no like guys I want to take here. So we're negotiating with three guys. Hopefully we can get all three, even though I think the Fournette's one gonna be unlikely. I'll boost it a little bit more to like 5.3 mil. I don't want to pay him too much. So let's go see if we can get both of those guys. Alright, so we got Chidobe Awuzie, Leonard Fournette rejects, and OJ Howard accepts. So there we go. So we get a nice receiving threat for Minshew and a nice corner to pair with CJ Henderson. Team's coming along pretty well with our dude declining that Eifert. That's nothing. We'll just keep him on out. So that's a good corner to pair with our boy CJ Henderson. Rashawn Melvin's still here. Can we release him? We'll just release him, even though we're not going to be saving that much. We'll take it here. We can honestly just draft the running back because the running backs are easily replaceable in this game, so I'm not too mad about not signing. But the Chidobe Awuzie and the OJ Howard signings were huge. So now let's go ahead and send it to the draft where we have 2 first round picks. Pretty good. We could probably get an O-line with one of those picks or a running back or another corner. Alright, here we are. In the draft, let's go ahead and start the draft here. We have the number one overall pick, obviously, because we were terrible, and the Rams pick got us picked 12, so not that bad. Quarterback is the position I'm looking at. Hopefully, in the new scheme. I know people are going to want me to take Levi Bacon. But I'm more focused on probably grabbing another corner, to be honest, or we can look to grab a tackle. was your running back. Mason Schmidt looks pretty. We're actually taking Mason Schmidt with our first overall pick. 77 overall, hidden development, 7th in true value. He looks really good all around, hopefully. He has a pretty good development. And let's go ahead and simulate to the 12th pick here. Where Levi Bacon's still available. Eli Arnold looks fantastic. Looks like the new Leonard Fournette. Let's go ahead and take him here. 77 overall. Normal development, that's not good. But he looks pretty solid. 6th in true value. We've got him at 12. We traded Antoine Woods for our running back. That's a bad of a trade-off, if you ask me. Now, with our second up pick, who do we take here? Marcus Prince looks pretty solid. We could maybe use a D-tackle. I don't know. Let's go look at the scouted guys, actually. Let's go down. There's Manny June. Do I think he's going to be better than a 73? Probably not. Tackle won't do bad. Well, Case make. Ooh, this is a steal. Let's take him. 77. Normal development again, dude. I'll take it, though. I'll take it. Steal of the draft. He looks very small. His arms look miniature on him, but we didn't have a third round pick because we traded away to get Antoine Wood to get the first round pick from the Rams, and then we used that to draft a running back. So, fourth round. Do we take a running back? Do we take him to be our third down back? Or is the first time they got taken thing? Is there a good tackle still left? There is Rich Spain. I'm actually going to take Demarius Roberts, another running back. 66 overall normal development. Probably going to have him as backup. Yeah, but it's super slow. So we get him some snaps and our new running back some snaps. Fifth round here. There's still a guy. If he's taken, they're all taken. Cool, I don't want to take another guy. Should we just do a red gem? Oh, it's the fifth round. I thought we were a lot later in the draft. We'll just simulate to the end of the draft here, so there's really nothing else to do. I think that was a good draft. The developments weren't there. But hopefully they can gain development traits. I believe this is year number 3. Is it year 3 or 2? I don't know. I'm not really keeping track. Probably should. Team. Not too bad. Receiving core looks pretty good. Running back quarter doesn't look too bad. We could probably improve in a couple of spaces. Didn't get a corner, which I kind of wanted to grab there. We got a new starting tackle. Got a couple of starters here and there. Actually, year one. We count. Yeah, I guess we're gonna count year one. So this is we're going into year number 3. I don't know if I'll do more. I'll probably do more. Either around 6 years or something like that. There's a fly. Alright, it's heading out, so we're good. So, ow, heck. Alright, so let's go ahead and just send them straight to the midseason. So the team is an 82 overall, 81 overall offense, 84 overall defense. I'm hopefully we can have a better year. We did change the playbook around, so maybe that helps us. So hopefully year 3 is the year. Alright, so midway through year number Trace, which is 3 in Spanish, we are 6-1. Told you to use the schemes. The schemes is the only thing that really matters in this game, so we're going to upgrade our guys here. There we go. So let's go and see what our tackles of development is. Demons is up to an 85. He has just star development. Team, this is actually not even looking at that. Bad of a team. Alright. We're slipping someone. Alright, now we have to negotiate with guys. So, Yannick Ngakoue wants a contract. Joe Schobert wants a contract. DJ Chark. Ooh, this is gonna be kind of expensive. Kind of expensive. So Yannick Ngakoue is going to get this 5-year deal. He comes back. Schobert. Kind of want to see what he can do. Chark has been our best receiver this entire thing, so we're gonna give him a 6-year deal. Harrison. He's got a good development, so let's go ahead and sign him. Brian Lynch. That's these guys I don't really care about. I mean, I could resign Tavon Bryan, but I don't know. So we're signing quite a bit of guys here. So now let's go ahead and seemingly to the playoffs where we actually have a shot of making them. How? Oh my god, we started the year 6-1 and we missed the playoffs. We won 2 games.
Oh my god.
I'm cursed. I swear I'm the most cursed person in this world. How do we go? We want 2 games for the rest of the year. How? How is that even possible, dude? Only to me. Only to me. This never happens to anyone else. Nobody else is. What do we lose? What's the playoff schedule? I don't care about playoff schedule. That's bogus. Alright, 6-1. The only loss we came to against the Chargers. And we had a massive losing. So after mid-season, we lost to the Titans. Alright, 6-2. 7-2. 7-3. 7-4. 7-5. 7-6, 8-6. All right, a nice break. Let me just lose those games. Of course. Oh, okay, let's go check out the stats. Minshew, those aren't bad numbers. Khalil Arnold had less than 4 yards per carry, 5 touchdowns. Receiving, Laviska Shenault had a big year, 54 receptions, 892 yards, 10 touchdowns. Howard wasn't even that bad. Sacks allowed 17 for Mason Schmidt. He is Schmidt. That's funny. Tim Ryan, quite a bit of tackles for loss. Josh Allen with double digit sacks. Aaron Lynch with 9.5. Interceptions, 2 from CJ Henderson. Catches allowed. Chidobe Uzi led. We had like at least high 60s. But we only let up, most we let up was 54. Not bad. Josh Lambeau missed 4 or 5 field goals. We had the worst offense. Apparently the Chargers offense, when I use it, sucks. When I use it, it sucks. I don't know why. And Jalen Hurts won MVP with the Bears, of course. That's cool, dude. That's so fun. Coach of the year, we're not going to be up for that. AFC other player of the year, Josh Allen. That's... RTs, that's cool. The Chargers go 7-9. That's cool. T. Watkins, defensive player of the year, almost a rookie. Offensive rookie of the year is RT Blanchard. Khalil Arnold finished second. Defensive rookie of the year, Chase McDonald, which I believe was D tackle. So, if we want something, the Chargers playbook apparently didn't work. Oh my gosh, so...
playlist work with this team? Oh my gosh. Alright. So it looks like we're gonna change the schemes again, or we're just keep this. Now let's go to the Super Bowl week. Alright, Super Bowl is the two most OP teams in the game, Browns and Cowboys. So let's check developments. Here, any developments go up? None. Nada. Zilch. No developments. Cool. No developments on defense. That's just like our guys are developing. Some of the guys develop pretty like Miles Jack. Don't even look at yearly awards. Let's just go to the re-sign period. Alright, so I changed up our schemes a little bit. Our offensive playbook is going to be the Bears, and our defensive playbook is going to be the Cleveland Browns. The Bears always seem to do really good in sim. Browns always seem to do really good in sim. So we're going to, hopefully they can, you know, help us out. So now let's go ahead and simulate to resign period. Alright, now we have a couple guys to, what did I just do? So we have some guys to negotiate with. I don't know, I'm not going to resign any of these guys actually. Well, Schobert, he's going to start to regress. I don't want to give him that money. We'll resign Taven Bryan. We'll give him a 4-year deal, I guess. And he accepts. Everybody else can walk. So yeah. Hopefully we get, there's a couple of big names in free agency, like Patrick Mahomes. I don't know. Alright, so checking out the free agents. Mahomes isn't here between this point. Herbert's here, though. That's cool. So we don't need a QB. Running back. We already have a running back, and I don't want to really, you know, just replace running. We just drafted Ante, a superstar development. That's pretty cool. I think receiving core is pretty nice at the moment. We could use another tackle here. It's the left tackle. I forgot we had Jawan Taylor. Could use a right guard or maybe a center and put him at right guard, maybe a left guard. I don't know. We probably just draft one. See if maybe there's anybody else. Why didn't we do that? We need. Could use a middle linebacker, and the best guy available is the dude we let go. Cool. Corner. Don't really want to sign any of these guys. Free safety, we could use one. Is there a strong safety? There's Carl Joseph. So, not really. You didn't have a punter, so we're just going to go ahead and offer up on Braden Mann. We'll just give him a 5-year deal, I don't know. So, not really anybody I'm really interested here in free agency. So, let's just send him the draft. Alright, so we go ahead and trade away Steve Moore, I think his name was, and Adkinson in a 6th-round pick next year for the Vikings, 5th overall pick this year. So we now get ourselves a top 5 pick every single year. So I will take that, and now let's go ahead and simulate to the draft. Alright, let's go ahead and start the draft. Here, the Seahawks have the number 1 overall pick, and we have the 5th. Let's go ahead and sim straight to that pick here. I just heard something that was kind of scary. We can use a middle linebacker, actually. Mid first. No, another straight down. What could we take? Could Proc Hall looks pretty solid, I think. Will Wood. I think we're going to take Will Wood. Or Leonard Carey. Nah, Will Wood looks better. We're gonna take Will Wood. First round of talent. Let's go, Tim. 77 Henrik, 2. Second Drew Talley, we got him at 5th. He's gonna slide over to free safety. Because we lost
somebody, I don't know, Gerard Wilson, I think his name was, to free agency. Now we get a better guy who's same overall, same development, maybe the same development, and the, like, 6 years younger. So now we have the 17th overall pick. Let's see if one of those outside linebackers is available, and they are not. Is there any good middle linebackers available? There's this one, Denton Barth. That name makes me want to barf. look at me, I'm funny. I am super funny. Let's go from the bottom here. Wait for Von Roden. So that actually looks like a pretty good safe class. Who should we take here? Brandon Bernard? That's like, what's his, he's projected to go mid-first. We're around mid-first. Let me see the other guys. The left tackle, right end, left tackle, running back, free safety. Yeah, I think we're really going to take that corner. There, Jacob Bernard, mid-first, 72 overall, normal development, terrible zone coverage, that's awesome. Let's go to here to the second, wait, that was that a dumb pick? I think we literally just, yeah, he's going to be our fourth corner, that's cool. Maybe we could move Miles Jack in the middle linebacker. Cool. That could be the move. Might as well take him. We're going to take Terrell Duncan. See, don't think he's going to be 70, oh, 71 hidden. 27 the true value. Got him at 49. Looks pretty solid. Could use him for trade bait. That's kind of why we got him. I'm just going to go here to the third round. I don't think what anybody I'm going to probably gonna honestly just simulate this pick. We'll take this tackle, Greg. Not Greg, George McGee. 69 overall. Nice development. Nice overall. Jeez. We have a fifth round pick. Nobody's going to be available, so we're just going to submit to the end of the draft. Alright, here we are in year number 4. Why is it so bright? We are an 81 overall. Team is... Wait, we don't have a guard? I thought we had a guard. Probably, this is probably going to be the year where I trade away a bunch of unwanted guys for players or picks. What do you... We're going to slide Miles Jack to middle linebacker. Don't know if that's a good thing. He's now 92. And then we're gonna move. Let's say we could move him to left outside linebacker. This is the year, dudes. I think I'm sensing some good things this year. Now we have a need at the end. We're gonna move you to free safety. So it looks like we might have to make some trades. So people I could trade away. Probably just trade away depth guys that we're not using. I think that would be the move. Alright, so I'm gonna make a couple of trades here. As we can't trade, we'll see the next week. So Let's go ahead and see what here next week, and then we'll make a couple trades. All right. Team is looking pretty solid. I want to see if any available free agents are good that would start. Not that I can see. Ronald Jones. Wait, is Nyheim Hines? It's not Nyheim Hines. Nyheim Hines still have star. He does still have star. I'm going to pick up Nyheim Hines. It's not that bad of a pickup, actually. Any other guys we could take? Amani Hooker. Hooker. He a hooker. We got guard, maybe, and there's no good guards. Or Zach Fulton. We're gonna sign Zach Fulton here to the team. We're just gonna try to fill out the team here. Alright, let's go ahead and make some teams already looking pretty good. Alright guys, I was making some trades. I just wanted to check out what Terrell Duncan's development was. The trading away. See if he had maybe X Factor by any chance. And to tell you, and just to show you, I did not touch anything. I swear. He has Superstar X Factor. So that kind of wants me to trade away Minshew. Because I want to start this X Factor. I'm not trading away an X Factor QB when Minshew's only 8 overalls lower. So we're going to be trading away Minshew. I didn't see the coming. So let's pick a trade for an elite. Alright, so a huge trade as we trade away Gardner Minshew the second and Mitch Richter. Imagine saying that to them. Mitch Richter. I already messed up. And we traded our first round pick this year. I feel like we're going to do pretty good this year. So hopefully it's a late pick. And we go ahead and grab Kenny Clark, who's probably going to be our D tackle. But we can move him over to the end. Alright, another huge trade. We trade away Quincy Williams, third round pick next year, and a fifth round pick this year for Zach Martin. So I think that's all the trades I am going to do. The team is now up to an 87 overall just with those trades. So that means Zach Fulton is completely useless on this team. Alright. Team is now looking pretty solid. I'm going to move Cody Clark. Is he more DN? No, he's probably a pure D-tackle. So we're actually going to move Jason McDowell over to left end here. And he is a 79. So the defense, this team overall looks pretty solid. And this is only year 4. Remember, after this year, we have one more year. So, we have a Super Bowl window this year and next year. Similar to midseason. Alright, midway through the year. This is terrible. We're 2-5. This is, Terrell Duncan's already up to a 75. So by the end of the year, he's going to be like the same overall as Minshew. And he's also has a higher development as Minshew. He's also younger. He's also... Whew. He hasn't been developed. We feel good, but we know he has X Factor because I peaked because I was going to turn him away, and then after turning away Minshew. So Will Woods reveals he has, or just Will Wood reveals he has superstar development. I will take that 100%. Let's go. Let's go. So we have some negotiations to go through. So we're going to have quite a bit. C.J. Henderson, Mr. Schnultz. I feel like we can get a lot of these guys. Josh Allen is going to be my number one priority here. Please accept. Thank you. Linder, his contract demand is going to go down once he regressed. So, that'd be your. He says no, thank you. LaVishka, please come back. Baby, come back. Oh, God, I'm never going to say that again. Well, he wants better salary, Norvell. He's going to rest, so we're just going to wait until his demand of his contract goes down once he regress. Kaylorn Chaisson returns. Juwan Taylor. Isaiah Scott. So we're going to have to come back here to Henderson and LaVishka. Alright, as I'm renegotiating here, CJ Henderson says he's not interested. But. So I actually want to re-sign Juwan Taylor to a nice extension here. My God, you guys are such great little people. I couldn't say the other word because I'd get in trouble. So let's just go ahead and see if we make the playoffs. If we don't make the playoffs, this is the most cursed team in Madden history. All right, so it looks like we did not make the playoffs. We went 6-10. That's cool. Just love it when you have this monster team and you go 6-10. On our X Factor, QB has 4 upgraded points. It's cool. He has bazooka. I rarely see QBs with bazooka. I've never gotten a QB with bazooka in my life. Never. And I'm being serious. I've never seen a quarterback I've drafted getting bazooka. So it's kind of cool that we got bazooka. But hopefully, let's go ahead and finally, this is next year's the final year, and let's go into that final. Actually, let's go and check out the stats. I don't think I checked out the stats last year, or maybe I did. That's Terrell Duncan. Pretty good year from a rookie. Almost 4,000 yards, 25 touchdowns, 8 picks. Khalil Arnold is. Oh, wait, Naheem Hines? It looks like he split the carries. They had a total of 1,000 yards, 11 touchdowns. Yeah, the charge was pretty solid. Billingsley wasn't that bad. Just kind of sad. We went 6-10. Let's just leave 12.5 sacks from Josh Allen. That's great. Miles Jack. Looks like he might win defensive play of the year again. One of the worst offenses. So maybe the Saints playbook isn't the greatest. Maybe this team just is cursed. Andrew Hopkins. MVPs. That's cool. That's funny how that happens. AFC up to play of the year is Andrew Luck. Defensive play of the year, Miles Jack, but he can't go up in development. Up to play of the year, Terrell Duncan, obviously. QB wins it. Will Wood finish second. Individual awards. Miles Jack wins best linebacker. That's it. So, let's go ahead and simulate the Super Bowl week. Alright, so again, the Titans are in the Super Bowl. Maybe we just switch our entire playbook to the Titans. That's probably the way to go, because they've been in the Super Bowl 3 times, this thing. Let's see if anybody went up in development. Nobody in offense. And nobody on. I don't think anybody went in. Got developments on defense, unless I'm missing somebody. I think. No, we got the one that's kind of disappointing. Why am I going through this? I don't know. But apparently the Titans are always in the Super Bowl. They've at least been in the Super Bowl 3 times. So I'm just, might as well just switch my entire thing to Titans, since that's what. Since that's what. It's OP, I guess. Oh my gosh. Because apparently, they're so good in sim. I'm just going to do teams that are OP in sim rebuild. I mean, you just keep their basic team and they'll do really good. So let's go ahead and skip to the re-sign period. Alright, here we are in the re-sign period. Just as I anticipated, Brandon Linder's demands go down. I want to get him back. Hopefully, we could try to bring him back. Henderson, Trent has 16 mil, Trent's 11 mil. Norwell. I don't know, I'll see you guys before we sign these people. Alright, so. Shoot, what was I gonna say? I forgot what I was gonna say. Alright, so Linder is not interested. We franchise tagged. CJ Henderson and Andrew Norwell is not interested, so is Jawan Taylor. So we're basically losing our entire O line. In free agency, hopefully we can get it back in free agency. Let's go ahead and see our way to the final free agency of this video. As here we are in free agency period. We have $40 million left to spend, and Chris Carson is the number one available guy. And I am looking at a running back, actually, because our running game has been terrible this entire rebuild. So I'm gonna go with a little bit of a cheap option, like David Montgomery. That's more of the cheap option I am looking for, because I don't want to overpay running backs. I'd rather just get a cheap one. And him right there, and also now we can sign the rookies, I guess. And the receivers, there's really nobody there. Tight ends, nobody there. And left tackle, we're good. Left guard, Andrew Norwell's still there. And he's the best guy by far. So I am going to, I'm trying to lowball him. Pretty bad here. I'll give him that. It's center Brandon Linder is getting a lot of offers. And I'm actually gonna bid on Cesar Ruiz, actually. And we can move him over to center. And I don't want to try to bid on Brandon Linder and lose him. So we'll just go with these guys here. Also, I'm also looking at cornerback, and there's Amik Robertson. I'm not sure to sign the guys that I think that should have hidden development and then make him hidden development, because I think that's kind of, you know, cheesy, because then I would just sign all the guys and then give them, like, the development I think they should have started with, and it would be kind of unfair. So we're going to try to get Amik Robertson here on a cheap contract here. And then we need to go out and sign a kicker. Josh Lambeau is the best guy. So let's try to re-sign Josh Lambeau. I'm here, and we're not, you know, trying to. We're still quite a bit of money left, but let's see if we get the guys. Alright, so David Montgomery accepts, Josh Lambeau accepts, Andrew Norwell accepts. We got three guys. Who the other guys we didn't resign? Amik Robertson, we're getting outbid on, so that's cool. So we're just going to withdraw our bid there and try to bid on a different corner. Why not? Let's bid on Chris Harris. I know he's old, but we'll see what he can do. We'll just sign him just because he's an X-Factor. It's the only reason why we're signing him. Because nobody's going to bet on him because he's old as balls. So we can probably get him for pretty cheap here. So we got a decent running back that hopefully will do good in our scheme. I mean, usually with our running backs, they don't do too good, so. I forgot we need tackle. So we actually need to go. Probably a bit on a tackle. I forgot we lost Jawan Taylor. He probably already got signed, so. Oh, that's cool. I'm looking for a right tackle. Jawan Taylor is still there. But the Colts are bidding on him, so I don't know if I want to. Which is like a nice right tackle that that was a rookie and I like. Cesar Ruiz is gonna play center. And let's bid on Josh Jones and try to get him on the team. We're just gonna try to get as much guys as we can. So we're gonna have three guys here. Hopefully we get all of them. And let's see if we can. Alright, so we got Cesar Ruiz and we got Josh Jones. Fifth year options, we have one for Caleb Billingsley. Sure. This is the final year, so it doesn't really matter on who's we're gonna sign. We're just trying to make the best team as we can possible. So Chris Harris still hasn't accepted our contract yet, unless we get outbidded. He just wants more money. I'll give him a little bit more money. There's good. 68 points. There you go. And let's go and see to the draft. All right. So Chris Harris did not accept our contract, which is kind of annoying. So let's go ahead and start with the draft again. We didn't have a first round pick because I said thought we were gonna do really good, and we ended up going 6-10. So that would have been a high pick. But it was for Kenny Clark. I don't know. So really, what could be? We could use another a corner because Chris Harris was like nah. Like Javonte Swain. He's first round talent. Why not? Let's take him. We could be happy in development. No, he's just pretty normal. Cool. No, really, nobody's gonna start. Because we're in the final year, everybody's developed and stuff. And plus, this draft class looks kind of buns. You know. Ooh, except this left. What? Except James Brewster. What? That's crazy. Ooh, you're sitting there. That's a steal. We didn't even need a first round pick to get a first round talent, dude. I'll take that. That's pretty cool. Maybe he'll start and move. Ooh, that actually would be very nice. We'll get Silas Houston. Looks decent. Pass coverage from Marshall. Take it. Depth linebackers. Always cool. Why did I do that? And we'll just submit to next pick and we'll probably pick up a fullback. I don't know. The center picks aren't doing anything unless he's a fullback. Or kicker or punter, and the real scared are trash. So what I like to do is I like to go with the dude with the weirdest name. Dustin Britt. Michael Dillinger. Travis Holmberg. Ken McDowell. Javier Preston. Michael Dillinger sounds kind of odd, so we'll take him. He's 66 overall normal blocking. Doesn't look too that bad. We'll take him. But I think he's like the only fullback we've ever gotten in this entire rebuild. So the draft is we got a potential starter on defense. O-line. Oh yeah, I need him. Actually, Cesar Ruiz, our center. I'll take that. And then you will stay our right guard. There we go. You just boost up to an 83. Actually, we're gonna. Oh, who's already playing tackle? We're gonna have. Why is that doing that? That's weird. Oh, he's playing. McDowell's left. What if somebody left end on the team? Like James Brewster, right end. And we're gonna start it because he's probably higher overall than the other guys. Maybe he has the. You know what? I don't care. Final year. Let's go check out his development to see if he's even worth starting. Nothing crazy. But he's going to start over that normal development guy. Try to maximize his... There we go. He's going to be your right end. And it's cool. We do have a third corner, so I'm going to... Hopefully Chris Harris is there. I don't know. But final year, this is the year that we should... We haven't made the playoffs this entire time. And we've seen the last two teams I've been, last year's team was pretty good. Chris Harris is there. We'll take him. you sign up with us anyways. So this is the final year. Hopefully we can do really good. And let's try to make a playoff run. Alright, we sim straight to the playoffs. And it looks like we made the playoffs for the first time in this rebuild. I'm so proud of our guys. I'm proud of how they performed. I'm proud of our team. Man. I'm pretty sure every time I made the playoffs, my rebuilds. We have a 92 defense, 87 offense. This team is destined for a dynasty. 100%. Team is looking really nice. The Billings is actually higher overall. Everybody's a depth chart on defense. Kobe has an offense, don't. But. We have Cam Newton? Why? Why? Just. Apparently, we have Cam Newton. I'll take it. Two really good quarterbacks. Two X-Factor quarterbacks. That's pretty sick. So. I definitely. Seeing that, so we can put him at north. It's funny we have Camden in our. Hopefully, we can get the dub against the New England Patriots. Come on, I don't like to jump into the games. Just preferences. Of course, they lost to the Patriots. Of course. Jaguars are Kirksey Madden. No matter how good you make them. You're never gonna amount to anything in the NFL. In Madden. So a failed rebuild 100%. Didn't do anything. We made playoffs once and then we lost one and done. It is our Jets rebuild, we won a Super Bowl, and I don't think we won a Super Bowl in our I don't think we won a Super Bowl in our Bengals rebuild. Kinda sad. This team was looking pretty good, 8 overall. But at the end of the day, a lesson for y'all, the Jaguars are cursed. Tell me pretty lies, look me in the face. Tell me that you love me, even if it's fake, 'cause I don't fucking.